I'm going to tell a story about somebody dying from a broken heart. That sounds sort of like a Hollywood story, and you don't really die from a broken heart, right? Maybe it's a heart attack. Maybe it's, no, this is real. And it is not a heart attack. It's not where someone had plaque and the plaque released and it formed a clot, you know, the typical heart attack. Yes, that's the number one cause of death. But there is a reality, a medically known thing. It's actually called Takotsubo's heart failure or cardiomyopathy. Heart failure is obvious. Cardiomyopathy means heart muscle problem. And yes, that can happen from a broken heart. Takotsubo, so that's obviously Japanese, or it sounds Japanese, and you might think it was discovered by a Japanese doctor, Takotsubo. It is Japanese, but there was not a Dr. Takotsubo. Takotsubo is an octopus trap. What is dying from a broken heart got to do with an octopus trap? Well, actually, it's got a lot to do with it, and we'll talk about that in just a few minutes. First, let's talk about the story. The patient is a 70-year-old woman, and this is a true story. This is not something I made up. She's standing in the room of an ICU. She's next to the bed where her husband is lying. The doctor comes in, and the doctor says within the first 30 seconds, he's dying. He won't survive the day. There is nothing we can do. He didn't think to ask what her perception of the illness was. He didn't think to have her sit down. He didn't think very much about the situation. So the next thing that happens is the patient collapsed to the floor. She landed face forward. Blood started flowing from her nose. It appeared that the nose and a few teeth were broken, but that wasn't the biggest medical problem she had. When you took her pulse, it was very, very weak. It was faint, and she was barely breathing. The patient and the husband both died within 24 hours. So yes, the doctor was right about the husband, but he had never predicted or thought about the patient dying then as well. And we hear stories about that where people tend to die when their loved one dies, but not usually that quickly. We'll talk about that issue a little bit later. But she had broken heart syndrome. As I said, this is a known medical entity. This is Penn Medicine. They had a grand rounds on this issue where they had an educational section on it. And this is what it's got to do with octopus POTS. So when you take a look at the normal heart, the left ventricle, which is the major pump, has more of a triangular shape, usually in a normal heart. But in the Takotsubo heart, you get this blunting. It looks like the shape of a Japanese octopus pot. So why do they have octopus traps? As you can guess, they make sushi. They eat octopods, octopi, whatever you call those things in plural. Again, what is Takotsubo's cardiomyopathy? Cardio heart, myo muscle, pathos meaning bad. So the ventricle pump muscle stops working. And as I said, this is totally different from your typical heart attack. There's no plaque, there's no clot causing this problem. There's no loss of blood flow. It's still flowing to the ventricular muscle, but there is heart failure. There's loss of muscle function. And you may remember, we talk about bioindicators, chemical bioindicators a lot. Troponin is an indicator of loss of blood flow to the heart or strain to the heart muscle. Troponin does go up. So there are some theories that maybe this is loss of circulation at a microcirculatory method. The bottom line is, we don't really know. This is one of those things in medicine where it happens. We don't really understand how it happens, but it is very powerful. Most people will survive this. It does happen in older people, tends to happen more often in older ladies. If you start looking at the American Heart Association or cardiologist training tapes, they tend to talk about, it's like a lot of things. If you really start looking for it, you find it a lot. The reason you don't find it or hear about it that often is people don't really look for it. Now let's go back and talk about this patient. Was the timing and method of death, I mean, was that good timing? You know, some people might say, well, you know what? It saved her a lot of pain. We don't know that. We don't know if it was best for her to die then. We don't know if it was best for the family. It have been avoided? Well, we don't know that. We're sort of assuming that had the doctor done his discussion differently, it might have worked better. We do know that. The doctor could have done better. And we do know this. Broken hearts can kill. Thank you for your interest. So I'd like to talk with you a minute about the webinar. People don't understand what the webinar is. It's actually a great way to get some access to healthcare that you're just not going to get any other way. You actually get the lab tests yourself at a local lab, a Quest lab near you, for the inflammation panel and the OGTT and the insulin survey. These are things, inflammation and prediabetes, that your doctor just does not know about. And here's the thing. Harvard Health and many others have said, look, sudden death is not always so sudden. The Hollywood picture that it's a bolt out of the blue is not realistic. It's more like real lightning, preceded by clouds, wind, and rain. Stop that metabolic storm before the lightning strikes. And here's where that metabolic storm comes from. It's inflammation, and it has to do usually with prediabetes. So again, we actually get labs, we go over them in the webinar, and then you can start finding out how you can prevent that heart attack others said that you couldn't even predict. We can show you how. Thanks.